nigga must. You hate on a nigga. I don't understand why you hate on me, nigga.
We don't understand.
Show love, nigga. It don't show nothing. It don't cost nothing to show a nigga love.
Are we doing this getting money?
Show a nigga some love, nigga.
Wabbledy dabbledy.
Niggas out here don't love me, nigga. Damn.
What's up, you guys? I am back with another video, an update. I was recording before, but I decided to restart the video because I don't know how to hold this phone, this mic. And genuinely, I just have like a really low voice, so this main camera will not be able to pick up my voice. Unless it's my mic, I do not know. But excuse me for holding this while driving, for real. But yes, you guys, I am back with another video, and I'm just back with the update from the last video. So last video, I think my dad had just passed away, I think. And if I didn't say that, that nigga did. That fool passed away and my dad died. February 25th at 7:35 p.m. He died of a stroke, and... yes, if I didn't already like cover that last video, I'll kind of touch base like right now. But yeah, my dad, who was a heavy drinker, he had liver failure, so he just, and essentially at the end of everything, he was just brain dead. So since I was the only one here in the U.S., like, I had to make the decision to, and a nigga, pull the plug, right? I think I remember talking about the family drama with my family from Cuba. I think I did touch base on that. I don't want to talk about it, but let me update you to where I'm at now. I caught you up. Let me tell you where I'm at now. So I got my dad. I'm not going to tell you how, but just I had to. Okay, I'll tell you. So I had to get a lawyer. And basically, they just had to give all the rights to me. And that's what I did. So, after I got an affidavit. I don't know. But basically, after I got the rights to my dad, basically, that was like it. Like, he was ready to get cremated. Because that's really all we needed. Like, was the majority of the kids to cremate, whatever. You could go back and watch the video. But, yes, long story short, my dad passed away. February, and he got fucking cremated in April 22nd, and I had no help. Man, I had to pay for that fool to get fucking cremated, like my poor dad. But this is what I'm trying to touch base at here, right? I had no help at all, and I was just impatient because I just wanted to get shit done. I just wanted to get shit done. I just wanted my dad back. I just didn't want nobody to fuck me up, right? So I really didn't ask for help. I did ask for help for my family in Cuba, but I really didn't ask for help from strangers or just from resources, right? Because I'm like, fuck, I need to get this shit done. No one's fucking helping me, and I don't have time to fucking wait for people. So I just got all this shit done, right? But this is what I'm getting at here. I was watching this video on the Kendall Ray YouTube about, I forgot his name, I'll post it. But it was just a story about like a mom and her kids. And basically, I guess the husband killed the son. And God bless his soul, the son. It really did rub off on me because the mom, at the end of that video, the whole purpose why Kendall Ray made that video is to spread awareness and so people could help the mom and the sister fight this because they really haven't gotten justice. So what I'm trying to get at here is when I was watching that video, just how she broke down, not even for her son, but how she broke down as a woman. She said, like, kind of quote for quote, like, we need help, I need your help, my son needs your help, my daughter needs your help. And honestly, I just fucking started breaking down. I just broke down crying because I think she doesn't, I don't think she realizes, like, the braveness and the courage it took to do that in front of millions of people to ask for help. And it kind of just really got me down today because I'm like, fuck, like, I've been through this before. I've had this talk before with other strong, independent women who have helped me. They're just giving me advice, right, who are like me. And when she said that, when she was asking for help, like, it really just, it made me cry because I'm like, fuck, like, if she could ask for help in front of, like, millions of people, I could ask for help. And I just feel bad, like, not asking for help, like, with my dad. But you guys, everybody was letting me down. Everybody was letting me down. No one wanted to help. It's either, oh no, I don't got it right now, or I can't, like, so, like, fuck it, I'm gonna do it myself. You feel me? But hold on, keep running out of motherfucking storage. But yeah, anyways, you guys, sorry about that. Keep running out of motherfucking storage. But anyways, you guys, sorry about that. But yeah, I forgot what the fuck I was really saying. Oh yeah, for my dad, like, okay. Let me sum this all up. So I've been having health issues, right, with my nose. Today I went to go get checked with my nose, and I forgot what the fuck they told me. But just seeing that lady, seeing her video, and just her being vulnerable, like, as a woman to a woman, like, that shit really just fucking hurt. Like, not hurt my heart, but touched my heart. And that kind of, what she said, like, asking for help, like, motivated me to go to the doctor and get fucking help for my nose. And I think it kind of just really bummed me out, and this is why I'm really making this video, because I really just want to say, like, if you need help, get help. Like, and I just feel so dumb, like, fuck, even with my nose, like, I feel like I should have just gotten help sooner. And even, like, kind of with my dad, like, I just feel like, fuck, I just wish I had help. I just wish I would have had, like, I did have help, but, like, immediate help from, like, family, you feel me? But, and also, too, like, it just has me thinking, like, fuck, like, I just wish I asked for more help, like, with my dad. Like, it's a weird analogy, a weird whatever, but just going to the doctor today just triggered all these fucking, like, domino effects on me, and it's like, I don't know, like, I've been through a lot. I have been through a lot, and for me to ask for help, this is why. Not to say, like, everyone's bad, but I think I just asked the wrong people for help, or I just asked the people who use me for help, or don't reciprocate what I give out. Not even counting brownie points, but you know what I mean? Like, I can't really count on you, but, like, I think that's why I don't ask for help, because I ask for help from the wrong people. And even, like, with my immediate family, like, there's no help there on my mom's side. No help there. I haven't been getting help since I was 17. Got kicked out. That's a whole other video. But I have no fucking help. No help. So I think it's kind of like a little bit of, like, PTSD a little bit to ask for help. So for me personally, like, I'd rather just fucking struggle and go through the most than to ask for help. Like, that's just how I am. And at a real young age, like. Someone who was older than me, like a mentor, like a big sister type, like big sister, big brother type, whatever. She was like a mentor. And she was a real strong woman. And I remember, this will always stick with me for the rest of my life. But I remember she said, you know, sometimes being a strong woman, or sometimes it takes a strong woman to know when to ask for help, to know when to be vulnerable. And in a way, I just, like, fuck, like, I just wish I just asked for more help when I came to my dad. But at the end of the day, like, I just feel like I needed to get shit done. I couldn't depend on nobody. I needed to get shit done. I didn't have no patience. But I don't know, you guys, just get help if you need help. Don't be, I think for me too, I know I'm just rambling, but I feel like for me, I'm just kind of embarrassed and like too prideful, like not, I guess ego driven. I'm just embarrassed and too prideful to ask for help, like for real. And I don't know what that is. I really don't know what that is. I guess it's because I've always just been on my own ever since a kid. Like, I basically raised myself. Like, I've always just been on my own. So to ask for help makes me feel like less than, like a punk, like not woman enough, you feel me? But I think what I'm learning today is like it's okay to ask for help. Oh, I just bit my tooth. It's okay to ask for help. And if you're someone like me, like male or female, if you need help and if you have the resources, reach out and get help for real. Because I think this feeling that I'm feeling now is way worse than the feeling when I ask for help, if that makes sense. Like being a fucking hard-headed, stubborn ass bitch, like that's more regret that I have instead of like, I don't know, being embarrassed. Like, I don't know if that makes sense. I don't know if you guys are trying to get what I'm trying to say, but I think today I'm just regretting not asking for more help, essentially, you feel me? But that's all I really wanted to say. The other day I just got the death certificate for my dad. And yeah, I just really wanted to come on here and say, like, if you have the resources, ask for help, you guys. If you have people who are willing to help you, like don't take advantage of the people who want to help you. Because I think my pride and my ego has gotten in the way of like a lot of my blessings, you know. And sometimes like strangers, they want to bless you, like, and sometimes like why do people want to help me, like why are these strangers helping me? And it's because like I know God works through people, so sometimes you just gotta receive your blessings, you know. But my poor dad. But yes, you guys, I just wanted to come on here and say that. Let me stop. I gotta fucking get in my house. I gotta unlock my gate. So, yes. Thank you guys so much for listening. And I'll be more consistent with videos now that I'm settled in my house, you know. So, I don't like crying, dude. I don't fucking like crying. I've been holding this shit in. But alrighty, we'll see y'all later and take care.